we see air pollution linked with things like anxiety, suicide ideation, big studies and we see increases in pediatric hospitalizations related to psychiatric disorders linked to air pollution. My own work has been around indoor air quality, so another type of air pollution and cognitive function impacts. So we've done studies of, say, office workers where we've changed the air they were breathing. We introduced air pollution into their space. In this case, it was air pollution like off-gassing from dry cleaning and dry erase markers without them knowing in a double-blind study, and then we test their cognitive function performance. And we see they perform worse on these tests. And these tests are things like, how do I seek out and utilize information in the world? How do I make strategic decisions? How to respond during a crisis? And that was in a double-blind controlled study. But then we did that same kind of study globally, and we had about 450 office workers, and the same thing. We looked at indoor air quality and these cognitive outcomes, and this will tie into the work here. We actually saw a link between PM2.5, so main component of outdoor air pollution, mm-hmm. and acute performance on these cognitive function tests. So air pollution measured at your desk, most of which is coming from outside, and these acute tests. So across all these dimensions, if it's office workers, university workers, kids in elementary school, high school students, we see over and over the impacts of air pollution on the whole range, mental health, anxiety, all the way through higher order cognitive function.